two movies based off real life people opened this past weekend.
And here to tell us if they are any good, our movie critic, Will Loper.
Hello, hello.
Hello. Hello.
So, yep, first movie I saw was The Butler by Lee Daniels. He also did Precious. He wrote and directed the movie. This is the story of Cecil Gaines, a butler who works in the White House through eight presidents from Eisenhower up to Reagan. The movie is inspired by true events. It's a fictionalized version of a butler who worked in the White House. Very well acted, very well done. Forrest Whitaker plays Cecil Gaines. He's getting a lot of buzz for his performance, and rightfully so. I was a little worried about Oprah, if she would be able to disappear into the role, but she did a very nice job. I thought she did very good. Although the movie hits all the watershed moments in civil rights history, there were times I wish the movie focused on maybe just one or two events instead of glossing over them. It's trying to cover a huge expanse of history, so sometimes it doesn't give the attention each of them deserves. The movie works best, though, when it shows Cecil's son and the conflict between the son and father. He navigates through fighting for African-American rights. They sort of disagree on how to go about working for African-American rights, and so you can take a look at this dinner scene between the father and son after Lewis has been gone for several years.
What was the name of that movie, honey?
In the Heat of the Night.
In the Heat of the Night with Sidney Poitier?
Sidney Poitier is a white man's fantasy of what he wants us to be.
What are you talking about? He just won the Academy Award. He's breaking down barriers for all of us.
By being white. By acting white. Sidney Poitier is nothing but a rich Uncle Tom.
Look at you. All puffed up. Put your hat on your head. Coming in here, saying whatever you want. You need to go.
What?
Okay, so yeah, so there's a very big conflict, between the father and son about how to go about it. So I really liked it a lot. I ultimately am rating it four guest celebrity appearances presidents out of five. You got Robin Williams as Eisenhower, James Marsden as JFK, John Cusack, Richard Nixon, and Alan Rickman of all people playing Ronald Reagan.
Oh,
so
wow.
Yeah, it was really fun seeing them all pop up.
Oh my goodness.
Didn't Jane Fonda play Nancy Reagan?
Jane Fonda, yep, as well as Nancy Reagan.
Wow.
So yep.
All right, next
movie, the biopic, Apple founder and CEO Steve Jobs. Ashton Kutcher plays Steve Jobs. He does a decent enough job. The biggest problem I had with the movie was that Steve Jobs just really, the movie did not portray him as a very likable person. I don't know a whole lot about Steve Jobs, but he was really a jerk. So as the movie went along, I was kind of getting bored, and I realized the reason why is that I just didn't care for the character at all. I really had no interest in seeing what happened to him, and start to get a little long at the end. He kicks his girlfriend out after she tells him she's pregnant. And it would be fine if it showed him, like, as a genius, you know, as a lot of people have said he is. But you really don't see that besides him being really concerned about the fonts and Mac computers. So
what did you give this?
I give this one 2.5 retro Apple logos out of 5. Not as good. So Butler, yes. Jobs, not so much.
All right, so next week.
Next week, checking out The World's End and Frozen Ground.
Ooh.
So,
never a lack of movies for you to see.
Never a lack of movies, no.
All right, well, thank you.
Yep, thanks.